We heard in the press conference a lot of talk about how Jeremy is different from Joel Quenneville. Why do you think it's important they brought in somebody that maybe has a different style than Coach Q?
Recurring theme, as you hear John McDonough and Stan Bowman talk about Jeremy Colliton and what he brings that that warrants this kind of a transaction. I think what we're seeing really, I think, is a kind of a symptom or an example of this new breed of coach we see in the NHL. Gone are the guys, and I don't suggest for a second that this is Joel Quenneville, but gone are the guys that simply roll out a game plan, bark at players and say, you need to be here at this moment in the game. You need buy-in today. You need somebody that works relationally exceptionally well with players and gets the player to become part of the solution rather than just rolling out a game plan, expecting a player to adhere to the game plan. You want somebody that kind of partners with players, draws them into the mix, and is successful at getting a player to buy into the ownership, take ownership of what you're trying to do on the ice. And I suspect, just watching Jeremy Colliton, the way he's kind of managed his the two teams that he's been, he's headed up to this point, I think that's an important part of the skill set. So from Bowman's perspective, I think you're looking to adopt a little bit of that because you've got a somewhat younger franchise, at least some bright, shiny pieces who are relatively young.
Yeah, and I would say a couple of things. You heard Stan Bowman talk in the press conference about the communication skills of Jeremy Colliton. So, I mean, that's one of the things that stands out for the general manager, at least moving forward. The other thing to me is, and this is, the, you know, in the real world here, right, this is a young guy that is going to have to lean on Stan Bowman and is going to play the players that Stan Bowman and the organization want him to play. He's not going to be a Joel Quenneville who's won three Stanley Cups who may, you know, get his back up and say, no, I'm going to go in this direction. And there's, so that relationship is going to be different. The fact that they brought in the assistant coach they brought in, you were mentioning beforehand.
Barry Smith.
Barry Smith, yeah, who is a longtime colleague of Scotty Bowman, who was on that staff. I think you played for Barry Smith along with Scotty Bowman. And so now there's that connection because, again, this is all this discussion behind the scenes. And Stan was quick to say, hey, there was no power struggle here. I had a great relationship with Joel. I owe a lot to Joel. But that is at odds with people who know Joel Quenneville very well. And it has, you know, they've talked about a different type of situation in Chicago. So we will hear, I guess, from Joel at some point down the road about that. And maybe he'll just say, hey, that, there was no big deal because these guys want to continue to get on with the business of life.
I think for the most part, you know, I would accept most of the Bowman explanation with one notable exception. You know, business is business, and you're always going to have disagreements with your peer in terms of what we should be doing at this moment in time. The Mike Kitchen firing post failure to make the playoffs that year and the way it was done, I think that's
and
the
that's,
one thing
and that's
that
a good close friend of Joel.
A lingering hang-up in
and
all this.
And trading away, you know, a the Panarin without a lot of conversation. Yeah. The fact you trade away Yarmolson, who by all accounts was one of Joel Quenneville's really go-to defenders. So I think that there was some things back and forth. It may not have been personal, but it may have been about the business and the way things are done. When you bring in Jeremy Colliton to the situation, he's not going to be doing those things. He's going to play the players that management wants him to play, and hopefully they'll get on the same page, and maybe this team could go forward. But I would suggest that the roster, you know, the roster is not as good as it was when they were winning three cups.
And I would say, too, to your business versus personal point, is that sometimes things are intended from a business standpoint. Doesn't mean they're taken from a business standpoint. Because there's two sides. There's two perspectives to every story, right? So there could be a case of that going on as well. Stu, I wanted to get your thoughts as well. Every time we see a coach get fired, people talk about, oh, well, this is going to light a fire under the players, and this is going to affect the players.
Yeah.
We look at the Chicago team, and the core, the nucleus of this team, the Canes, the Taves, the Keiths have played for a long time under Coach Q. How do you expect, if at all, for this decision to impact them?
Sometimes change for the sake of change can be a good thing. And you've got some guys that all they've ever known is Joel Quenneville. So if Jeremy Colliton's able to successfully walk to the center of the Blackhawks room, get their attention, and really roll out a game plan and a vision that makes sense, he communicates it in a really simple, straightforward way, and he's able to motivate this group, all these guys want to do is succeed at the end of the day. All they want to do is be part of the top eight in the Western Conference. If they get a sense that he can do that with confidence and he rolls out a game plan that is worthy of their trust, I think you've got a recipe for success at the end of the day. But let's be clear, this is too, at the end of the day, a gamble because a new coach is an adjustment, especially a guy that really is in his infancy with this organization. You're talking about a team that pre-Quenneville was capable of making the playoffs. Now it's, you know, you've got to factor in how does the new coach impact this roster at this moment as he steps into the...
And you know, the other thing too with Kane and Toews and Keith, and particularly with Kane and Toews, they were there at very early stage of their career when Joel Quenneville was brought in. And at the time, if you remember, Denny Savard was the head coach of the Chicago Blackhawks, and he had a very close relationship with those two young players. And he was fired after four games of that season. Joel Quenneville came in, and in the end, Joel Quenneville was the right guy at the right time. And Denny Savard, while he was upset at first, found a way to kind of be comfortable in that role that he had as an ambassador for the Chicago Blackhawks. So it worked out great all the way around. I guess what I'm saying is that those were young players in the league. They've been around a long time since then. They understand the business of this league. They know what they have to do. They're making a lot of money. They have to play well.
Yeah, and they also understand what it takes to win as well. And they seem like very competitive guys based on their resumes. I think they'll be willing to listen to what their new coach has to say, because these are guys that are used to winning and would like to probably get back to it.